sleep. Now bond angle. Okay. Second bond parameter. Bond angle may be defined as the average angle between the orbitals containing bonding electron pairs around the central atom in a molecule. So if this is the molecule forms here, here is one bond length, here is some bond length using the orbitals. Whatever angle is there, that is called bond angle. Now you will see diagrammatically. It is measured in either degree or sometimes degree minute, or if you want to express correctly, then degree, minute and second. Bond angle tells about the way in which orbitals are distributed around the central atom in a molecule and therefore determining the geometry of a molecule. That means if you want to, by knowing the knowledge of bond angle, we can tell what shape it will take, what geometry it will take. So that all knowledge you will get from the bond angle. A lone pair of electrons at the central atom always tries to repel the shared pair or the bonded pair of electrons, because of which the bonds are displaced slightly inside, resulting in a decrease of bond angle. This point somewhere I cleared. In a molecule, if all are bond pair, it is having least energy. If in a molecule, along with the bond pair, lone pair is there, so lone pair is free, so it will create some problem. Well, which problem? Repulsion problem. So lone pair, bond pair, repulsions are there. If more number of lone pairs are there, then among the lone pair, larger repulsions are there. So that will affect the bond angle. Let us see with the example. The HCH bond angle in methane is 109.5 degrees. The HOH bond angle in the water is 104.5 degrees. And HNH bond angle in ammonia is 107 degrees. All three have same shape, but though they are same shape, but bond angle differs. Why? Please see here. All are tetrahedral. Tetra, four, hedral, corners. These are figures in the 3D. You have to imagine 3D. Okay. So they are 3D pictures in space. Now, tetrahedral methane, tetrahedral ammonia, tetrahedral water, all are tetrahedral structures. But you see the bond angle. Bond angle is decreasing from 109.5 to 107 and from 107 to the 104.5 degrees. Why? Again, depends upon what? The number of lone pair and the bond pair. In the methane, all are bond pair. Okay. So whatever bond angle is there, that is the 109.5 degrees. But why less here? That can be explained with lone pair. So on the nitrogen, one lone pair of electron is there. Okay. So this lone pair, it is a free, it want to repel with this one. Okay. So here, they want to go for more angle, slightly more angle. Okay. But when it goes here, this is repelled here. So this will repel. So due to repulsion, it will shrink this side. It want to go this side. Like water, sorry, like methane, 109.5, but not possible, because if it wants to go to 109, this will repel because it's free, no. That's why small shrink is there in the angle. That's why small less degrees here. Now here, two lone pairs in water, one lone pair here, one lone pair here. So this wants to go, this will pull here because repulsions, no. So this will repel. And this also they will repel. So they want to expand, but repulsion is there from the lone pair. So this is shrink and this is shrink together, slightly less. So more the number of lone pair, more is the repulsion between the lone pair, bond pair. More shrink is there, less bond angle is there. So diagrammatically it is understood here. Now third bond parameter, bond enthalpy or bond energy. We know that energy is released at the time of bond formation between the atoms. Definitely, when the two active atoms, energetic atoms, when they combine, so energy is given out because they go to the least energy state, so energy is given out. This means that the bonded atoms possesses quite less energy when compared with individual separated atoms, and this increased energy is required to break the bond. This means, let us take hydrogen and the chlorine atoms or the molecules. When they are separate, H2 separate, CO2 separate, they are highly active, they are highly energetic. When they want to combine H2 and CL2 to go for the HCl, that time H2 will come out with its energy and CL2 will come with its energy. When they combine, so they go to the least energy. So energy is given out. What you want to say? Atoms in the bonded condition are in the least energy. So whatever energy is given out, the same energy, if you supply, it will break. Okay, that you want to convey. So in the free state, they are highly active, they are highly energetic. When they will combine, they will go to the least energy state. Energy is given out. And this energy is called bond dissociation enthalpy. Energy required to dissociate, to break, that is called bond dissociation enthalpy or the bond energy, or and is a measure of bond strength. That means more the bond dissociation enthalpy means what? Whether a bond is strong or less. We'll discuss by taking the data in our next discussion. Okay. See. Bond. Now definition. Bond dissociation enthalpy may be defined as the amount of energy required to break one mole of bonds of a particular type between the atoms in the gaseous state. So always I told in the ionization enthalpy, take to the gaseous state, free state, one mole. The time you apply some energy, that energy required to break the bond. Okay, for one mole, you take one mole of hydrogen. Okay, in the gaseous state. So apply some energy. When all the one mole breaks, you know how much energy is required to break one mole of hydrogen? That is the bond enthalpy of hydrogen. Okay, it is expressed in the kilojoules and always per mole, no, for one mole. So kilojoules per mole is the unit for the bond enthalpy or the bond energy. For example, the bond dissociation enthalpy for HH bond in hydrogen molecule is 435.8 kilojoules per mole. This is expressed here. Okay, right. Now, similarly, the bond dissociation enthalpy of ClCl in Cl2 is this much, and of iodine this much, and HI this much. You please compare with Cl2 and iodine. Iodine is less, whereas Cl2 is more. Why? Smaller size, close approach, less bond length, stronger the bond, more is the bond enthalpy. Here they are far away. Okay, iodine is a bigger one. So when they go for bigger one, so attraction is not there, bigger bond length, aram she can break. So when the size is more, they go for the larger bond length away from the two. So it is called less energy. That is the meaning here. I told, that's why now it is a measure of a bond strength. Similarly, for molecules containing double bond like O2, triple bond like N2, bond dissociation enthalpies are, see, O double bond, O is how much? 498. N triple bond is what? 946. Why it is more? Three bonds are there between the two N in the N2. So to break all the three bonds, we require more energy. To break only two bonds, slightly less energy. And to break only one bond, single bond, less energy. So single bond, less bond enthalpy. Double bond, more bond enthalpy. Triple bond, still more bond enthalpy. Because more the number of bonds, bond multiplicity, more close they can go, stronger is the bond, so more energy requires. That is the meaning. So we conclude, strong bond will be formed in the molecule if it has higher bond dissociation enthalpy. Okay, so when the bond dissociation enthalpy is more, bond is strong. So bond enthalpy means what? It is the energy required to break one mole of a particular sample. Same energy is required to add also. So bond enthalpy is the energy required to break one mole of sample or to make one mole of a sample. Data, please refer, and you can conclude afterwards. It's already told in the case of multiple bond, in the case of single bond, or size also matters. So everything I told, so data will clear your all theoretical point.